Hello and welcome to our third Anyline screencast. In this video, I'm going to show you how simple it is to build your own custom use case with our Anyline OCR module. So today, we're going to build a password scanner for preset Wi-Fi passwords. This is just one of the endless use cases you can build with the Anyline OCR module. Feel free to try it out and show your creativity with your own custom scanning use case. Before we can start, you'll need a couple of things like Android Studio, an Android device, a USB cable, and our Anyline Examples project. If you haven't opened our Examples project with Android Studio yet, please do so now. If you want some help with that, you can check out our previous video here, which will guide you through all the steps. Once you have finished this step and the example project is open in Android Studio, we are ready to start. As I have already mentioned earlier, we're going to build a password scanner demo using the Anyline OCR module. So the first thing we're going to do is to navigate to a similar example in the OCR package of the project. For this use case, the best starting point is probably the scan IBAN activity. So we're just going to copy this scan IBAN activity and create a new one. Let's call it scan Wi-Fi password activity. We'll just leave the standard layout and only adapt the view config to customize our scan view. The view config is set here. As you can see, we set the config via JSON file. You could also do this using XML attributes, but we're going to use the JSON file as well. You can find all the view config files in the assets directory of our app. So let's copy the IBAN view config and name it Wi-Fi password view config. If you have tried out our IBAN scanner in the Examples app, you may have noticed that the cutout is very wide but not that high. For the password scanner, we will probably need a higher cutout with about the same length. So we're just going to change the ratio from size from 10 to 1 to let's say 10 to 2. So we want to have sharper edges at the cutout corners, so we're just going to use a corner radius of 3 instead. Maybe let's try out a different color for the cutout as well. We're going to use a light blue for the default color and green for the cutout feedback. If you're not happy with the other feedback options, you can change that as well. So let's turn off the beep sound by setting this to false and maybe use a different animation. I personally like the resize animation, so let's add the animation here and use a longer duration than the default of 75 ms. We do not need to fill color with this feedback style. That's only necessary if you use contour rect as animation style here. Since we are using contour points, we're just going to delete the fill color property. But you can also leave it here. It will be just ignored. Okay, I'm quite happy with this config. But if you want to make some more changes, you can check out the complete list of available parameters in the Anyline view configuration section of our documentation. The link to the documentation is in the comments of this video. So we're already finished with the first half of our example. The next step is to configure the OCR module itself. For this, we have to change back to our scan Wi-Fi password activity and find the Anyline OCR config in the code. As you can see here, the scan mode is set to line. This is perfect if you want to scan text of an unknown length. Since every password is of different length, this setting is perfect for us. The other scan mode would be grid. The grid mode is the right choice if you want to scan things with a constant layout like the bottle cap codes, for example, where we always have a 3x3 grid. Next, we have to set the Tesseract languages. We're going to try it with the ones that are already defined here. If you have a use case where those languages do not really work that well, we have a great tool to improve this. All you need is the font or a similar font than the one you want to scan, and our trainyourtesseract.com site. We're not going to train a font, but let's check the site out for a second. All you need to do is enter your email address, select what characters you want in your trained data file. Maybe you only need uppercase letters, so you can deselect the others. Then you have to upload your font file and click on Train Now. You will get the trained data file per mail within moments. The link to trainyourtesseract.com can also be found in the video description. If you want to use your own font, you have to copy this trained data file in the Assets Test Data folder here. And then call the copy trained data function with our file and the MD5 hash as the string. Next, we need to set our character whitelist. Since we hope for a secure password, including upper and lowercase characters, numbers, and all kinds of special characters, we either extend our character whitelist or we simply delete this setting completely to allow all characters. Note that if you know the allowed characters, you should always restrict them with this parameter, because it improves the scan process significantly. But since we don't know what characters will be contained in the passwords, I'm going to just delete it. It is also important to limit the size of the characters we want to scan. If the minimum height is too low, you might get a lot of small artifacts that can slow down the scan process. If it is too high, it may filter out small characters and you may get wrong results or no result at all if you filter the characters out altogether. Similar things apply for the maximum character height, so to find a good setting for those values, it may take some trial and error attempts. For the password scanner, I will use a minimum character height of 30 and leave the maximum character height by 60 for now. The confidence parameter gives a level of how likely the result will be correct. So if you set a value that is too low, you may get a result quite fast, but it may not always be correct. If you set it very high, it will be more likely to get correct results, but the scan process may take longer. I will just leave it at 65, which for me seems like a good compromise between accuracy and speed. With the validation regex, you can verify your result. Since we're looking for a random password, we cannot use this. I'm just going to delete it. The Remove Small Contours option is quite handy if you're looking for capital letters or numbers only. But if you deal with small letters or special characters, you should probably set these options to false, because it can remove things like the dot on small letter I, which can lead to wrong scan results. Since we want to scan all kinds of characters, I'm just going to set this to false. We will set the Remove White Spaces options to false as well, since passwords may contain white spaces. And the last parameter is the minimum sharpness. This is to avoid processing of blurry images. Since those images most probably will not lead to a valid scan result, we want to skip them and only use relatively sharp images to speed up the scanning process. Again, you should go for a good compromise between sharpness and speed. So let's leave it at 66. That's it. We're done with the Anyline configuration part. Now all that's left to do is to add our activity to our list view, and we can try out the password scanner on the device. Let's head to the example activities XML and create a new item in the example activity string array and call it scan Wi-Fi passwords. The string will appear red and we'll fix it in a second. But first, let's stay in that XML file and scroll down to the other string array for the activity classes and add our scan Wi-Fi password activity here. Now we're finished here and we'll add the scan Wi-Fi password string to the strings resource. The item in the list view shall say scan Wi-Fi passwords. That's what we are going to type in there. The activity will have a header label, which we will call Wi-Fi passwords. We'll also add this in the strings XML and call it title underscore Wi-Fi. Now the last thing we need to do is to navigate to the Android manifest and actually add the activity there. That's it. Let's build the project and deploy it on our Android device. So here we are. The example app is up and running and we're ready to try out the password scanner. What I've got here is the information on the bottom of a router, and I'll just scan the network key from the label. Works great, no typing necessary. This was just a short demo on how easy it is to build a custom use case with our SDK. If you want to try it out in an actual Wi-Fi scanner app, with this demo included, have a look at the WifiEye repo on GitHub. You can find the link below. I hope you enjoyed building your first Anyline use case, and if you have any questions or feedback, just leave a comment or contact us via mail at hello@anyline.io. Thanks for watching, have a great day and enjoy scanning!